Archery is one of the fastest growing segments in the hunting industry across North America. With increased hunting opportunities like longer seasons and certain firearm discharge laws, it's inexpensive and the ultimate challenge for getting up close to your quarry. Crossbows are gaining popularity in many parts, mostly due to the ease of operation and the pinpoint accuracy they provide. All this talk of crossbows and hunting has got me excited. In fact, today I'm traveling to the northwest part of Quebec to visit Kipawa Lodge in hopes of calling a bull moose in the range of my Equinox.
The moose hunt here, we have an archery season that starts mid-September and for 2 weeks, it goes to the end of September. And then we have a week lapse in between, and then our rifle hunt starts the first week of October and is a 2 week season as well.
And to enjoy some late season walleye fishing.
Wicked looking little critters, eh?
Congratulations, Mike.
Look at this brute.
This country was built on fishing, hunting, and trapping. Pursuing wild game in the vast lakes, rivers, and forests has been a part of Canada's heritage for over two centuries. Back then, it was about survival. Today, anglers and hunters act as stewards with the focus on conservation, wildlife management, and habitat preservation. Whether you're urban or rural, fish or hunt, you should support sound wildlife management. And proudly say that I am an angler and hunter.
The Ontario Federation of Anglers and Hunters celebrate 85 years of conservation proudly presents Angler and Hunter Television. Brought to you by Canadian Tire, a proud partner of Angler and Hunter Television. Mercury Marine and Lund Boats. Yamaha ATVs. What kind of Yamaha are you? Browning, the best there is. Excalibur Crossbow, compact recurve technology. The new Matrix changes everything. And Yukon Gear.
Keep on pulling, buddy.
Oh, he got off and he was huge.
Oh, big one.
Recently, we invited other outboard owners to look deeper into Mercury Verado.
The mid-range throttle response is amazing.
Got a lot of power for low RPM.
Whoa.
I can't get over the power that it has, how quickly it accelerates.
The torque is unbelievable.
Verado is up to 13% quicker than other four-strokes. Visit mercurymarine.com to see more ways Verado beats the competition. Mercury Marine, look deeper.
Feel that bad boy?
It's not about the shot itself. It's about all that came before it. A company that's given back to conservation so that the tradition of hunting will continue. A leader in innovation since its founding. It's the legendary excellence you've come to expect. You've got that history in your hands. Now it's about settling the crosshairs, focusing on that moment in time, and one legendary trigger pull that changes you. Winchester, the American legend.
I guess my first Yamaha was 1986, and after that it was Yamahas, Yamahas to no end. When I look at timber property that I'm going to buy or be harvesting, you need a good reliable machine to get you through the swamps. Pretty rough going some places. Different people have asked me about, you know, why I buy Yamaha. I keep buying them because of the reliability and the product that they make is just what we want. I'm Barry Elmhurst, owner and operator of BW Forest Products, and this is my Yamaha.
Closed captioning for Angler and Hunter Television is provided by Winchester Ammunition, an American legend.
This season, I'll be attempting to harvest a variety of wild game from all over Canada with my Excalibur. From wild turkey and moose to white-tailed deer and black bear. But first, let's take a look at what goes into making one at the Excalibur factory in Kitchener, Ontario. It's a real eye-opener to see the quality craftsmanship and the precision engineering that goes into the Excalibur. Knowing just how well-built this crossbow is will give you peace of mind and confidence when out in the field. The OFAH has teamed up with Excalibur Crossbow and in 2012 unveiled the Excalibur Archery Range at the Mero Cortolucci Hunting and Fishing Heritage Center, giving local youth a place where they can be introduced to hunting and hone their skills, giving them a head start into joining the angling and hunting community. All this talk of crossbows and hunting has got me excited. I met Wayne and Barb Morrow at the Toronto Sportsman Show, and we got onto the topic of moose hunting. Now Wayne is opening his operation up to moose hunting and invited me there to check out the place and enjoy some Quebec hospitality.
Barb and I have been here now for 25 years. Since that time, we've upgraded with a bunch of new cabins, the new main lodge, added rental boats, motors. We have a fleet of 14 rental units now. And so we're a remote location, 22 miles from the town of Kipawa. It's a big, beautiful lake with walleye, northern pike, and lake trout.
Day one of our Kipawa Lodge moose hunt. Wayne came in here and set me up with his ground blind. We were expecting rain, but obviously the weatherman was wrong. I'm over an old cranberry marsh here that's usually flooded, but it's been such a dry summer that it's dried up pretty good, but there's a lot of moose tracks in it. Usually, you know, every half an hour, 20 minutes, half an hour, you call.
I was going to try to use an electronic call I picked up at Canadian Tire.
Set up a Tinks moose and heat smoking stick. You stick it in the ground, burn it, and it burns for about an hour to 2 hours. And it smells like moose and heat estrus. And it's wafting all around. You could probably see the smoke drifting by us. It smells pretty good, but I'm gonna call again here. Another half an hour or so, but so far so good. The weather looks good and feels like definitely could be a moose coming through here. I like the looks of this spot.
Gear up with Canadian Tire.
Canada arguably has the best moose hunting in the world. From coast to coast, these silent giants roam our woods. Encounters on highways and national parks are common with motorists, but hunting them can be a real challenge. Your best odds at bringing a moose into archery range are by calling. Now, during the rut, bulls respond to cow calls and the challenge calls of other males. Being able to mimic these sounds will help up your odds in the field. Now, if you're not adept at imitating a moose through a birch bark horn, I suggest you check out the Flambeau Mad Moose Mega Cow Call. This easy-to-use reed-operated cow call will bring in rutting bulls looking for action. Combine this with Tink's synthetic moose lure, and you'll be sure to draw out even the wariest moose. To see more tricks for calling moose, check out your local Canadian Tire store or visit canadiantire.ca.
Coming up, the search continues for that elusive moose.
The new Excalibur Matrix changes everything. Matrix is the first compact recurve crossbow. Matrix is faster. Try 380 feet per second and more powerful. Matrix is lighter, better balanced, easier to cock, quieter, has less recoil, is more consistent, more accurate. It can't be dry fired. It can be decocked. Matrix is superior in every way. The new Excalibur Matrix changes everything.
They're up there, you know. I've been to the ship. I've seen things. I've smelled things.
Look, I'm trying to forge here.
They fool you with the smell. They got me, but I escaped.
Yeah, from the loony bin.
The scent was like a blood trail, but it's deception.
Get away from me.
Beware, my friend. Trust no one. Trust no one.
Think GPS is just for getting you to the lake? Think again. The new iPilot wireless GPS trolling system can hold your boat in place like an electronic anchor. Record and retrace productive fishing paths, automatically keep you on any bearing you choose, and take total command of speed and steering. iPilot controls your boat with wireless GPS precision so you can focus on fishing. And it's only from Minn Kota.
Wayne made arrangements for me to go up in a float plane and get a perspective of the size of Kipawa Lake and maybe even spot a moose we could set up on.
Oh yes, Lake Kipawa, there's about 1,800 miles of shoreline, and there's about four or five different arms on the lake, and where you're hunting is just a small little tiny fraction of the swamps and the marshes that are around the area, and as you've seen yourself, there's many of them, and they just keep going on and on and on, and it's like a chain.
Moose hunting more than any other hunting is about timing. Yeah, the rut has to be on, especially with archery, the rut has to be on, and there has to be a bull in the area that's willing to come looking for a cow. Now this guy's hanging out with a cow and a calf, so he might not come to calls, but we'll do our best.
The best part of coming to a lodge like this is the fact that there's always fishing to enjoy, no matter what time of year you visit. In my time between moose hunting, I spent the days and late evenings hooking into some fantastic Kipawa walleye.
There he is.
Look at the graph, you can see them. There's a group of them down there. He's coming up. There he is. Hooked him in the bottom lip.
Ow!
Gotta be careful with pickerel. They got sharp stuff all over them. Right here, look at that. It's like a razor blade. Hear that? He stuck me with it. Get bigger. This one feels like it might be better. And... woo, feisty. Not big enough for the net yet, but not bad. You're eating them. I think they got a 13 or a 14 inch size limit here. Anything under goes back. Wow. Hooked him real good. Getting there. Work my way through them. Don't you worry. I'm just trolling away through these narrows. We saw Wayne and the guys trolling. They got some nice ones. And I caught me a fish trolling. There it is out there. And, oh, should I risk it? Should I risk it? Oh boy. It's funny, they're blue here. They call them blue pickerel. Should I net him? Let me net him. He's just barely hooked. Got my trout net. Got me a walleye and a trout net. This blue walleye. Wow, he's hooked good. No, he obviously swiped at the bait trolling it because he's got him hooked in the bottom. Dark! They have a bluey green, almost a gray tinge to them. Not a bad looking fish. Maybe I'll make one more pass. Goes to show you that if you're not fishing at noon, you can catch them.
Ready.
Here he goes. Bye-bye.
Gulp Alive presents The Fishing Edge. Got him. Oh, yeah.
When you're up north on these clear lakes, pristine wilderness lakes, there's a couple different ways to catch fish, but obviously when low light conditions are around, you've seen we've been trolling some little deep diving crankbaits like this here. There's a Rapala and there's a Matsuo crankbait. Cotton Cordell makes a Walleye diver. You want to have a big lip, and the trick to doing it right is to let out a lot of line. I'm talking like 150 or 60 feet of line, and it'll get that bait down 25 or 30 feet. Without downriggers or without even a dipsy diver or putting a weight in front of it. But the trick is to let out a lot of line and troll that bait at, you know, one and a half miles an hour, and until you feel it vibrating, and you'll catch all sorts of walleye, as you've seen here in low light conditions. Now, in the middle of the day, when the sun's shining, those walleye go and lay on bottom. What I like to do is just get a little 3/8 or a 1/4 ounce jig head, and this Berkeley twitch tail. It's a new little minnow here. I got a package here, I'll show you. But basically all you do with that is you drag it on bottom, and it's real subtle, and it's a 3/8 and delicious little morsel here. You just drag it on bottom and that little tail wiggles, and the walleye will peck at it, peck at it, peck at it. I mean, I don't know how many fish I've missed, but they just sort of peck at it, and then eventually if you just drop it back to them enough, you'll hook them. So middle of the day, jig deep water for fish on bottom, and then in low light conditions, just troll where those same fish were, but in that upper depth range, instead of fishing the bottom in 30 or 40 feet of water, fish with your baits 20 feet, 25 feet down, and you'll catch lots of fish.
Coming up, the adventure continues in beautiful Quebec.
More than a century ago, Browning introduced the auto-loading shotgun to the world. Today's Browning Silver continues that tradition with greater reliability, softer felt recoil, better handling, and more features than ever before. The Browning Silver, the auto-loading shotgun that does it all. Browning, the best there is.
Fish are gonna need a new place to hide. Exclusive side imaging from Humminbird. Scan more water faster with 480 feet of side-to-side coverage and see structure detail with amazing picture-like images. Humminbird, simply, clearly, better.
A new age of modern scope technology has arrived. Burris Optics presents The Eliminator. The Eliminator incorporates laser range-finding technology with automatic bullet drop compensation calibrated to your rifle and bullet combination. Burris Optics, leading the way in modern scope technology. Burris's new Eliminator rifle scope, changing rifle scopes forever. Just range them and eliminate them.
Now's the time you've been waiting for. Lund 1775 and 1875 Pro-Vs are back. Pro-Vs are built tough with double-plated hulls, marine-grade treated plywood, and reinforced transoms. Plus, Lund's exclusive IPS2 hull provides precise boat control and a soft, dry ride. State-of-the-art live wells, accessories, and tons of storage for rods and gear, making all Pro-Vs the choice of professionals. Visit your local Lund dealer and reward yourself with the best. You've waited long enough.
The beauty about Quebec is that we don't have a tag or a lottery system here. Every year you can either hunt a bull and a calf, and every second year you can hunt bulls, cows, and calves. A lot of our Ontario customers like that idea where they don't have to apply for a lottery and hope that they get a tag by the middle of August or something like that.
Day four, Kipawa Lodge. Nice morning, very still, fog. Burned off down this way, but down to that end where the water is, there still has a fog. We've talked to some other hunters in the area that have gone out with Paul from Kipawa Outpost, and he said no one's really had any response to calls. It's not been cold enough. We need a frost, I think, to get the moose rod to go in. We're not going to get one, so we'll just deal. he spotted a cow. But she ran into the woods pretty quick before we could get the camera on her. And she was only about a kilometer, maybe 2 kilometers, south of here. So if there's a bull in the area, he might be trying to tend to her, but with the calling we're doing, we might draw him over here. Beautiful morning, though. This is what a great way to spend a week.
Kipawa Lake, we have walleye, northern pike, and lake trout. Spring, summer, fall, it's a continuous fishery. You just have to change your tactics a little bit. And we do have whitefish in here too.
Just like that. He's staying down there, he might be better. Oh yeah. Look at that. It's a whitefish. Wow. I didn't even know there was whitefish in here. That is the coolest thing right there. Look at this. Now, whitefish are pretty hard to hold on to and they're slimy. But I had no idea there was whitefish in here. He's gurgling. This is great. There. They're hard to hold on to. And that's why. He came up no problem. Look at that. Oh! The hook came out and he went bananas and splattered me. Oh, I thought I was going to get a fish sandwich there, smack in the face. Wow. So there you go. We've been marking these fish in 30 to 50 feet. Now, obviously some of them are walleye, but I got whacked there and I couldn't really tell what it was. It felt heavy, and lo and behold, Lake Kipawa has whitefish in it. So lake trout, which is closed right now where we are, closed last week, but awesome lake trout fishing. Nice walleye, big pike, and whitefish. Oh my gosh, there's one right now. So I'm gonna kill my motor so I stop trolling. My rod just went like this. It took a couple of runs. The problem is when you're trolling, now I'm doing 1 mile an hour and I'm pulling on this fish with a deep diving crankbait, I don't know how big it is. Look at my bend in my rod, it looks good, but I'm moving against it. He's just coming towards us. I don't know if he's very big. And catching 100 feet of line later, another nice one. Ooh, that's a beauty. And they're not gold and yellow, they're black and silver, I guess, or blue. And this guy. Wow, he's still got some fight left in him. Look at the fins, wow. Wicked walleye. I don't know if you can see, look at that blue. It's almost like an iridescent teal blue. Not bad. Put him back. Not bad. Oh, he splashed me. Awesome. Everybody's moving into the narrows. It's the hot spot. It's the hot spot. Last week of September, moose hunting, fishing, eating like a king. Definitely worth coming up here. Come on. I had a lot of line out to get this bait down 30 feet. Oh, I'm gonna have to make a decision here. And is he a net-worthy fish? Oh, he's just a little guy. I'm just gonna lift him up here, I think. Whoa, he's heavier than I thought. What a belly. That's a good one, little Walter. Move steady, slowly. Whew. And one last one. Those are good looking walleye right there.
beauty.
All right, I'm gonna send him back. Ready? Go on and get bigger.
What a fantastic experience. Sure, the moose didn't cooperate, but the fishing, the food, the people, and the experience, well, they're all things I'll remember, and a good reason for you to make a point of visiting a place like this.
Angler and Hunter Television was brought to you by Canadian Tire, a proud partner of Angler and Hunter Television, Mercury Marine and Lund Boats, Yamaha ATVs. What kind of Yamaha are you? Browning, the best there is. Excalibur Crossbow, compact recurve technology. The new Matrix changes everything. And Yukon Gear. Visit Angler and Hunter Television online at ahtv.com. You can find more information on today's show and past episodes or other great websites of the Ontario Federation of Anglers and Hunters. Like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next week. And remember to conserve and protect the great outdoors.